The Accureta Soul, small but mighty. Let's get into it.
We've been excited to get our hands on this small form factor printer for some time. Accureta is a Taiwanese company that has been manufacturing 3D printers for 9 years. First released in 2021, the Soul represents their latest iteration in-office printing. Accureta is one of the top 5 leading 3D printers in dental at the moment, and the Soul represents their latest iteration in-office printing. It's a machine we've described throughout our testing as small and mighty.
All right, we've been using this printer for the past 6 months now, and in this review, we're gonna take you through some highlights and also a few lowlights of this printer. And then we're gonna do detailed ratings on a scale of 1 to 5, with 5 being the very best you could possibly conceive and 1 being very bad. And we're gonna cover a few topics. We're gonna cover ease of use, we're gonna cover the footprint, that is the overall size, we're gonna cover speed, and then quality of the prints. And then finally, we're gonna cover the resin portfolio.
Yep. And then we'll take a look at a couple of clinical cases that we've performed using the Accureta Soul before giving it our final verdict. Cleanie is a 2-stage wash system that's very easy to clean the drive mechanism, but it's extremely loud.
The Curie, 70 watts of power distributed over 31 LED bulbs. Generating 3 different wavelengths of light, 365, 385, and 405. This ensures a very deep cure. What we really love though is the ability to instantly upgrade all the resin cure profiles simply by inserting a micro SD card. The Accureta Soul is an LCD printer. This printer is powered by 54 dynamic LED bulbs, meaning they only come on in the exact location needed. And what this does is dramatically save lamp life, leading to at least a 10,000 hour unit life for this LED panel. Another thing that's really unique to this printer is the efficiency and uniform distribution of the light to the LCD panel. So you're getting about 95% light uniformity, which is one of the weaknesses of LCD printers that this printer seems to have overcome. I really like the XY resolution of this printer coming in at about 49 micron. It really enables sharp details, as you'll see in a minute. Super crisp objects are able to be delineated, such as crown margins, thin veneers, and implant screw channels.
The slicer for the Accureta Soul I found has a couple really powerful features. The auto supports are fantastic. It's one of the best that I've seen, while still having a great set of manual controls to allow for manual manipulation. Comes with a large library of preloaded resins to make it great for printing a variety of different things. One gripe I have about it is the screen manipulation tools are not super intuitive.
All right, so there's a lot of positives with this printer. Yeah. We really enjoyed using it, but there's also some negatives that I think we need to bring to light. Number one, and this is really important for me, the curing unit is relatively underpowered compared to some other curing units. For example, Rodent Sculpture takes about 20 minutes in the Curie, where in an Otoflash or another similar system, it could take 5 to 8 minutes to cure.
Yeah. You know, one of the other concerns we have is the lack of safety mechanisms to protect the monochrome LCD screen. So, you know, if the vat were to break or if you were to pull the vat out and have resin dripping from your build plate, there's nothing to protect that screen from getting damaged or destroyed. And so, you know, really, it's not unusual within the printer space, but definitely something that, you know, an improvement could prevent accidents or problems with the printer.
And then, you know, another thing is it doesn't have heat, so that's going to cause a lack of the ability to do fast printing on a larger vat. This is the largest build plate that you could get with the printer, and it's still relatively small compared to some higher throughput printers. So, you know, quality is really important, but it doesn't matter if you can't figure out how to use it.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we have to talk about the ease of use.
Yeah.
So from the time of unboxing to getting it first fired up to downloading the slicer and running it all, what do you think about ease of use of this guy?
I mean, 30 minutes or less, right?
Yeah, it was so easy.
Yeah.
There was no calling customer support to get a license and all this kind of jazz. It was literally plug and play. I'm gonna give it a 4.
Yeah, I'd go with a 4 too. I mean,
you 4 out of 5.
Literally just get the file there and hit print and you're good to go.
Love it. Really good on everything so far, but we have to talk about the elephant in the room.
Yeah, the footprint. I mean, nobody has a whole room to put their printers in.
If you're limited on space, there's probably not a better option than this. I mean, there's a couple smaller printers out there, but they're not this quality. Really think for the size, this is the best that you could get.
Yeah, for the footprint, absolutely.
Yep, so I'm gonna rank it a 5.
Yeah, I would say 5 too. You literally could fit this in the corner of an op if you needed to.
Even if you combine the wash and the cure, it's still tiny.
Yeah.
I mean, because you could do a crown, like what, 15 to 20 minutes, depending on the resin.
Yep.
On that little baby plate, that's awesome for same day dentistry. What do you think? I mean,
it's a pretty speedy system. I'd probably, what do you think, a 4?
I think a 4 is really good because if we look at it, it would be a 5 if we had that same speed on the little bill plate.
On
the large, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
That would make it a 5, but because the speed is really confined to the tiny plate, which is really for your 1 or 2 units, but if I had that same speed for the build plate that was larger, 5.
Right? Yeah.
So, you know, you could be fast, but not necessarily good. So let's talk about quality, because I think this is where I was the most impressed with this printer. You know, I have to admit going in, I was not necessarily sure that an LCD printer would meet the standard that I have with printing quality, because usually I'm a big fan of DLP, but I was very impressed. Let's take a look at some of the benchmarks that we printed. The first one is our 3D printing torture test. This, I was really impressed with the results from the Accureta sole here. The support tips holding up this lattice structure cube are roughly around 0.3, so 300 microns at the tip. And you can see, I could just peel off this cube very easily and break that off as we done here. And the lattice structure in the cube is 300 microns as well. So we were able to get ultra fine detail out of this. It even printed the 0.5 wow. micron. Yeah, it's incredible.
Awesome.
Yep, and then so the other benchmark that we have is this cube, which was printed on the actual torture test. Very impressed with that. I have not seen actually a better torture cube printed. Yep.
The other 4 benchmarks we have are things that you'll be printing in your office every day. The first one being the single unit crown. Really what we're checking here is occlusal anatomy and margin crispness. Printed really great. The next is a single unit veneer. It's about 300 microns thick. We checked this on a test die, perfect fit. So another great print. The third is an implant crown to a tie base. This is a true abutment tie base and we're looking at how well it could print to the anti-rotation notch. It was a perfect fit. We printed that 100 micron cement gap. And the last is a set of show mockups that we would print for someone who's looking to try in a new smile. Here we're looking for the accuracy along with the quality of the print for all the veneers. And, you know, surprisingly, looked amazing.
So, you know, I think I would rank this 4.
Yeah, quality. I would go 4 too.
I mean, it is impressive. It's all about the resin.
It's all about the resin.
I mean, really, these just generate something that we use in our patients' mouths. So the most important thing is the resin.
And you have been called the resin chaser.
The resin chaser. I think this has over 200 plus validated resins.
It's amazing.
It's completely open. And all the resins are built into the curing unit. They're built into the slicer. I gotta give it a 5.
I'd have to give it a 5 as well. Just the ability to basically choose almost any resin on the market and print that depending on what you're trying to print is just a level of freedom that is amazing.
I'm surprised. I mean, this little thing surprised me. So, phenomenal printer. Let's show a few cases of what we've done with this printer. First one, let's talk about 3D printed no prep veneers. We did, in this particular case, we did some 3D printed no prep veneers And we decided to print them out of a material called Rodin Sculpture. And we printed them on the AccuRed sole. These veneers are clocking in at about 200 microns thick. We characterized them using the Rodin Sculpture kit, and we went ahead and permanently bonded them on using Ivoclar's Adhese Universal adhesive with Varilink Aesthetic LC.
Yeah.
I love that stuff.
Man, the aesthetics on this case, I think outside of, you know, some really high quality, just stacked porcelain, it's hard to rival what we were able to achieve here. I was super surprised.
Yep. The best thing is we were able to print them all and basically have the exact replica of our digital design. So we have all the control in the world.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, now the second case is one that you did, where you did some pretty incredible inlays.
Yeah, the inlays, one of my favorite workflows. I used to absolutely dread doing this type of treatment with direct composite. This is a case, you know, a couple years ago I would have done with direct resins, but just with the power of printing and, you know, just the quality that we're seeing there, I'm doing almost all these cases as printed cases now. You know, the workflow is almost completely delegated, which is awesome.
Yep.
We even printed a couple buckle pits, which I know you guys are going to laugh about that, but the fit was amazing. And I said, why not?
Why not?
But, you know, you can check the radiographs. The fit is absolutely stellar. The aesthetics are great. The occlusion was completely dialed in and perfect. You know, I went from hating those kind of cases to absolutely loving doing this stuff.
No more diddling with sectional matrices and wedges and heme and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, just the ability to design and get the perfect contours on your restorations right out of the gate and know that, you know, you're going to be able to basically bond those in 5 minutes or less, and it's going to be perfect and it's going to last for years and years.
I mean,
totally changed my practice.
That whole design took what, 5 minutes? Under 5 minutes.
Yeah. You know, so overall, really love the printer, a lot of positives, definitely some areas for improvement. We're gonna rate it a 4 out of 5. You know, so great printer, check it out. You know, I think we've got some other printer reviews coming up. What's next, Wally?
I think we're doing the Pro 55S.